Hello everyone, I'm Rohan, senior developer at Bloomberg, working in the company's Pune office. So Bloomberg is a technology company working to create the most sophisticated platform for financial professionals. We are headquartered in New York, but we have offices in Pune and various other locations around the world. Do visit us at our booth G7 to find out more about the company. This is the slide for that. Okay, so we all write unit tests for all the modules we send to production, right? And we always annotate all our code so that we can run syntactic checkers. Of course, who doesn't? Well, not really. We've all sent code to production that what I would call is subpar quality-wise, right? So over in our team, we wanted to create a framework that allows you to improve the quality of your code. This summer, we had Pradyum Gedam interning with our office. You may know Pradyum as one of the maintainers of PIP, Virtual Env, and or you may have heard his talk yesterday on packaging. He created the first version of Pluto. So what is Pluto? Pluto is a framework for improving the quality of your code. It provides a command line interface and a programmatic API to automatically generate unit tests and annotate your code. So this is what the command line looks like. You say Pluto generate, give it a bunch of arguments, it creates a unit test for your module. Similarly for annotate, you say Pluto annotate, and it annotates all your code. But how does it work? Pluto works by monitoring code execution, very much like a debugger. It creates a hook in the interpreter using sys.setProfile, and once it gets a callback for a function of interest, it captures a bunch of metadata from that call. The things that it captures are things like function argument values, return value, and argument state before and after the call. And while it's at it, it actually also captures the type information for that call. And it does that every time the function is called. Once it has all this metadata, it is able to create unit tests and apply annotations. So let's look at an example. This is a lightning talk, so the example is going to be very simple. There's an account class, and there's a person that uses the account. There are a bunch of methods that don't have any testing, and we want to create unit tests for all of them. Simple. We say Pluto generate. You give it the set of functions you want testing for. You provide it the module name. In this case, the functions are all the functions in person class. You give it the module, which is obviously person. You give it an output file, and you give it a way to actually call these functions. Now, in this case is main. So this could be an integration test for your application, or this might be handcrafted test. In this case, main just creates a bunch of person objects and invokes functions on them. Cool. Once we run this command, you have a unit test that is PyTest compatible. How does it look like? Like this. So we create a data-driven test. We collect data for all the calls to the method. In this case, I'm showing only addFriend, but it generates for all the functions. All the calls to addFriend are captured. And using the parameterized decorator in PyTest, we create a data-driven test. What do we capture? We capture the state of the object before. In this case, we have a person named Mary, who we are adding a friend named John, which is the second line, the return value, and the state after the call. We use JSON pickles to capture the state of complex objects, because pickles easily allow us to store the value and recreate an object, and also because JSON pickling makes it very easy to add tests by hand. Now we can run the PyTest, and you can use the coverage plugin. And by doing that, we went from 0% to 95% code coverage, like that. But that's not all. We can also annotate our code. Similar to that, we provide similar arguments to Pluto annotate. We can tell it to override the code. We can tell it to use type annotations in Python 3 or type comments in Python 2. This is what the annotated code looks like. Okay. There are certain caveats. Because this code needs to be run like a debugger, it is called in process. All the invocations, the data is real-world data, but all of them are treated as baseline. So if your function has a bug, it won't be caught by Pluto. In generated code, most importantly, will require inspection and augmentation. So right now, we are using Pluto internally. It works even for fairly complex classes. We have a database microservice that uses SQL Alchemy, and we can get almost 60 to 70% code coverage for its unit tests. We don't want to internally release it and maybe release it to wider audience at some point. So do visit us again at our booth G7 to find out more about Pluto and Bloomberg. Thank you very much.